So I remember very vividly my third night on call. I started out my first month on night service, and one of the pages I got was that my patient was unresponsive. So I remember the trauma chief was in the same room as I was, and I, of course, you get ready, you read and all that stuff, try to prepare for intern year, but you're never really prepared for these moments. So I went over and, I told him what was going on, and him and the second year resident who was also on trauma walked over to the patient's room with me. Turns out by the time we got there, the patient was already coding. They, helped me run the code. I was able to reach out to my backup and let him know what was happening. The fact that I was able to have that support from the get-go was key. I mean, it was.
As a fourth year now, I've had the experience of being the chief on a clinical service on pediatric surgery. And I've now finally had the opportunity to, as a senior resident, take a junior resident through cases and continue participating in teaching medical students. I think it's been a wonderful experience for me as a junior resident, having my seniors take me through cases, and now having the opportunity to learn truly how to teach, which is a completely different skill set than just learning how to do the operation, in a way that is very well supported by our faculty.
I think something that's really great about the University of Wisconsin is that we get to start operating right away at the beginning of our residency. In the first 2 years, all of us pretty easily hit our minimum requirement in terms of case numbers, and that also gives us some room to get involved in bigger cases as well that maybe we wouldn't be exposed to independently as junior residents. One of my favorite experiences in my first year was joining one of our chief residents, Christina Papageorge, and Dr. Dan Abbott in the operating room for a Whipple. And just getting to see the anatomy and learn the steps of the procedure as a first year resident is a really beneficial experience.
One of my favorite parts of the rural program is the apprenticeship model that we work with Dr. Reynolds up in Waupun. She is a broadly trained general surgeon who also has a background in academic surgery. She trained at the University of Minnesota. And we are her right-hand man the whole time we are out there. So as second years, we learn her style, we learn all of her operations and how she does them. And then as we advance on through third years and fourth years, she starts knowing our skills, our strengths, and our weaknesses, and pushing us to do more of the case. She is one of the most patient surgeons I've ever worked with and seems to almost enjoy watching us learn and struggle through cases, even when we're struggling more than we normally would. She loves to work with us and make us better.
I was able to go to Ethiopia back in 2018, and I spent a few months there, really an entire rotation. Just seeing how medicine is practiced outside of the United States and learning from them while also teaching them the way we do things here. Again, before COVID hit this year, I was actually again in Ethiopia. I liked it so much my first time that I wanted to get more of an experience doing that. And especially for someone like me who was interested in global surgery and making this my career, that was a very exciting option for me.